गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा, लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद एक्सरसाइज 5.2। टिल 12th क्वेश्चन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 13। हाउ मेनी थ्री डिजिट नंबर्स आर डिविजिबल बाय 7? यू हैव टू चेक हाउ मेनी थ्री डिजिट नंबर्स आर डिविजिबल बाय 7। सो यू विल फर्स्ट राइट द सीक्वेंस, यू विल राइट द लिस्ट ऑफ नंबर्स स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द थ्री डिजिट नंबर एंड you will check for the first number and for the last number and you will write little bit sequence of number, list of numbers and from that you will find the value of n, that how many three digit numbers are there that are exactly divisible by 7. So if I write a one three digit number 100, 100 is not divisible by 7, 101 is not divisible. So the first number that is divisible by 7 is 105, okay? So as it is the three digit number and we are searching for the divisibility test of 7, so if the first number is divisible by 7, then if you add 7 to this, it will become 112. If you again add 7, it will become 119 and so on. The last three digit number is 999, which is not divisible by 7. Then if we search for 998, 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 714 but we are 5. Is it divisible? Is it divisible by 7? Two is left here. Seven fours are 28 plus 1. No, it's not divisible. Then you will take 997, which is again not divisible. Then you will check 996. 7 ones are 7, 7 fours are 28, not divisible. That means you will take, what you will take here? 994. So the last three digit number which is divisible by 7 is 994.
Ma'am, maine yahi kehna tha 994.
Yes. Kyunki aapke samne 7 twos are 14. 14 yahan chahiye ya 16 hai. तो 2 लेस कर दो 14 बन जाएगा, तो लास्ट नंबर आ गया 994. सो द लिस्ट ऑफ नंबर्स वी हैव रिटन एंड इफ यू राइट दिस एपी करेक्टली एज इट इज हैविंग द डिफरेंस ऑफ 7, इट मस्ट बी एपी बिकॉज़ द कॉमन डिफरेंस इज सेम. सो दैट मींस फॉर राइटिंग दिस एपी यू विल श्योरली गेट 1 मार्क्स. सो आउट ऑफ 3 मार्क्स, 1 मार्क और हाफ मार्क्स इज देयर फॉर राइटिंग द एपी. सो द फर्स्ट टर्म इज 112 एंड द कॉमन डिफरेंस इज डी, दैट इज 7. So now you want to find how many three-digit numbers are there. So starting from 105 till 994, how many three-digit number are there? So you will find the n, and an is given, that is 994. And the formula of an is a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to 994. A is 105. N is the number of term that we want to find. Now, you will take 105 on the right-hand side to reduce the equation 994 minus 105. What you will get here? 988. N minus 1 into 7. N minus 1, when you take this 7 on the right-hand side, it will be divide. 7 ones are 7. 7 twos are 14. 7 7. So N is equal to 120. So there are 128 terms, 128 three digit number which are exactly divisible by 7. Is it okay? Is it clear? Next question, question number 14. हाउ मेनी मल्टीपल्स ऑफ फोर लाई बिटवीन 10 एंड 250? हाउ मेनी मल्टीपल्स ऑफ फोर लाई बिटवीन 10 एंड 250? दिस इज अगेन सेम प्रीवियस टाइप क्वेश्चन 13 टाइप, बट हेयर द नंबर आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द टू डिजिट एंड इट इज टिल द थ्री डिजिट नंबर, बट इट इन द मिडल ऑफ द थ्री डिजिट नंबर. सो यू विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द 10 and you will check till 250 that how many multiples of 4 are there. 10 is not the multiple. Actually, we are searching for between. So 10 will not be the part. 11 is not divisible. 12. We are searching for multiple of 4. So every time you will add 4 to this. And the last number, check this. Is it divisible by 4? Is it divisible by 4? Divisibility test of 4 says if the number is last two digit of the number is divisible by 4, then the given number is divisible by 4. 4, 6 are 24, it's not divisible. So you will take 249, which is again not divisible. So you will take 248. So the last number is 248. Now this is again the AP. First term is 12, B is your 4, AN is your 248, and you have to get the value of N. So please start this question and tell me the answer. Yes, who will tell me the answer of this question? Yes, Janvi.
Ma'am, answer is 60.
60?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the 60th term, so there are total 60 terms which are divisible by 4 between 10 and 250. Question number 15. Question number 15 is, for what value of n are the nth term of this AP and the second AP are same? The nth term of the first AP and the second AP same. Let the nth term of this will be AN, small AN, and the nth term of this AP will be capital AN. Aapko keh raha hai which value of N? N means number of term nikalni hai, to N small N will be same. Let AN and A capital AN be the nth term of two APs. AN is equal to A capital N. A plus N minus 1 into D is equal to A plus N minus 1 into capital D, because the difference is not same, but N is same, rest of the things are different. So from here, you will write all the details. So before starting, you will write A is equal to 63, B is equal to 2. And for the second AP, A is equal to 3 and D is equal to 7. A is 63. Capital D is your 7. First term and common difference are different. So you will solve this. This will be your 60 plus 2N minus 2. This 3 we have shifted here. 63 minus 3 is 60. This I have multiplied. And on this side, this is 7N minus 7. This is 58 plus 7 is equal to 5N. This is 65. N is equal to 13. So 13th term of both the AP is same. So for N is equal to 13, their nth term is. Means dono ki A13 term jo hai, wo same hai. Answer is, for N is equal to 13, their nth terms are same. Done. Start the next question. Read out the statement. Sixteenth question, determine the AP whose third term is 16. Third term means her A3. Seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. Find the AP. Two things are given. Third term is 16 and the difference of seventh and fifth term is 12. A3 means A plus 2D is equal to 16. A7 is A plus 6D, A5 is A plus 4D is equal to 12. D we have got as 6. Put this 6 in the first equation to get the value of A. Put D is equal to 6 in 1. A4 are. Now the AP will start from the first term. Then common difference will be added to this 10. 6 will be added to the second term 16. Then again 6 will be added and so on. This is your AP. 4, 10, 16, 22, and so on. Differences of 4. Done. Question number 17. Find the 20th term from the last of this AP. AP I am writing 3, 8, 13, 253. जब आपके पास ये दे रखा होता है find the 13th term of the AP, that means you are starting from the beginning, from the starting of the AP. But now here it is mentioned that you have to find the 20th term from the last. Then you will use the formula an is equal to l minus n minus 1 into d. वैसे formula क्या होता है, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. अब यहाँ पे last से start कर रहे हैं तो आपका जो d होगा वो negative हो जाएगा, तो जो minus d था उसका minus यहाँ आ गया. जब आप starting से start करते हो आपकी first term आती है, अब लास्ट से स्टार्ट कर रहे हो तो पीछे वाली टर्म आपकी फर्स्ट टर्म बन जाएगी, दैट इज योर एन. इज इट ओके? सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर फाइंडिंग द nth टर्म फ्रॉम द एन. सो नाउ यू आर फाइंडिंग a 20, लास्ट टर्म इज 253, n इज योर 20 माइनस 1 एंड d इज योर, d क्या है आपका 5. सॉल्व दिस, 253 माइनस 19 इनटू 5, 95, subtract this, what you will get? 158. Okay, so this is the formula for finding the 20th term from the nth term from the last is given by a plus ki jagah l minus aata hai, bas baaki rest of the things are same. Eighteenth question is the sum of the fourth and the eighth term is 24. The sum of fourth term and eighth term is 24. Yes, listen, in every question you have to write the description. First term D, this is the last term, nth term, that you will write every time. Okay. So this thing is given. Now A4 is A plus 3D, A8 is A plus 7D. And this will be 2a plus 10d is equal to 24, a plus 5d is equal to 12. First equation. Second is sum of sixth term and 10th term is 44. Sixth term and 10th term. Sixth term is a plus 5d. 10th term is a plus 9d is equal to 44. 2a plus 14d is equal to 44, a plus 7d is equal to 22. This is your second equation. Now solve these two equations to get the value of a and d, and from that you can write your AP. Okay, so from there you can write your AP. A plus 5d is equal to 12, a plus 7d is equal to 22. Subtract, cancel, minus 2d is equal to minus 10, d is equal to 5. So common difference we are getting as 5. Now put this d in the first equation, put d is equal to 5 in 1, a plus 5 into 5 is equal to 12, a is equal to 12 minus 25, that is minus 13. So your first term is minus 13. Is it okay? Now, actually the sum of two terms was given. So we have used the formula of the nth term, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. A4 is a plus 3d. A7 is a plus, a8 is a plus 7d. Always reduce one term from this. 4 minus 1 is 3, 8 minus 1 is 7. So we have got two equations, and after solving, you will get A and B from here, and you will write the AP. And the AP will be starting from the first term, then you will add common difference, minus 13 plus 5, that is your minus 8. Then again, you will add the common difference to this, that's 5. Then again, you will add 5, it will become 2, and so on. So this is your AP. Now the question was, you have to find the first three terms. So I have written the first four terms of the AP. First term we have got as minus 13, and the rest of the term is minus 8 and minus 3. Any doubt? Any doubt, beta? Tomorrow we will start with the new exercise. In that, we will discuss the sum of n terms of the AP. And that is the last topic of this chapter. And that is very, very, very important. Two questions are pending from this. We will discuss one or two, depends upon the time. Yes, listen, on Thursday, you have test of your introduction to trigonometry, chapter number 8. The test will be in the form of the MCQ. In Google form, you will get the test link, and the link will be closed after 30 minutes. So you have just 30 minutes, and it is compulsory to give the test. Don't miss the test. And every time, whichever test we are having, the total of those tests and the average of those tests will be put in your PT2 exam. Now, let's start with question number 19. Question number 19 is, Subba Rao started work in 1995 with an annual salary of rupees 5,000 and received an increment of rupees 200 each year. In which year did his income reach to 7,000? Now in the beginning, he has started from 5,000 and every year he is having an increment of 200. So in the next year, his income will be 52. And after that, in the subsequent year, it will be 54. And in which year his income will reach to 7,000? Means AN is given as 7,000. Means you have to get the number of year. In how many year? Means in 1995 he started. And in which year his income will be 7,000? A is the first term. That is your 5,000. And D is your 200. So you will start from AN as 7,000, and the formula of AN is A plus N minus 1 into D is equal to 7,000. A is the first term, N you have to get, D is your 200, this is your 7,000. N minus 1 into D is equal to 2,000, N minus 1 is equal to 2,000 upon 200, that is your 10. N is equal to 11. So in 11 years, his income will be rupees 7,000. Can you tell me the year in which it will become 7,000? 1995 mein aap 11 add kar doge, kya aa jayega? Kya aa jayega beta? Add karke you will get the year. Okay. Start the 20th question. That is exactly same as this question number 19. You please do it and mark down the homework part. क्वेश्चन नंबर 14, 17, 19. 14, 17 एंड 19 इज योर होमवर्क. स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, 20th क्वेश्चन. In the 20th question, the first term is 5, next term is 6.75. Every time you will add 1.75 to get your AP. And if in the nth week his weekly saving is 20 rupees 75 paise, then find an AN is given. You will proceed in the same manner. AN is given as 20.75. A is your 5, B is your 1.75. And you will get the value of n. Okay. Yes, listen, beta. In the next exercise, we will use the formula to get the sum of n terms of the AP. And the formula is given by Sn, that is sum of n terms, n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into b. This is the formula for finding the sum of first n. One more thing, you can use this formula also, first term plus last term. And this formula is nothing else, it is derived from this same thing that I can show. First term plus last term, n by 2 means jitni bhi terms hai unka half. First term is a, nth term ka formula hai a plus n minus 1 into b, that you all know. A plus A will become 2A plus N minus 1 into B. That will be N by 2. So, see this. They are exactly same. So, if you write the value of Nth term, so both the formulas will be same. So, you will learn these two formula and you can use any of the formula to solve your question. If the last term is given, you will go for this. If the last term is not given, you will apply this formula. Okay. So, to start from the first question. First question 5.3. First question, AP is given. You have to get the sum of n terms, 10 terms. First is 2, 7, 12 till 10 terms. Aapko n terms means 10 terms ka sum nikalna hai. N is 10. First term is 2. Difference is 5. First term is given, but the last term is not given. So you will go for that formula. N by 2. 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So n is your 10, 2a, a is your 2, n minus 1 is 9, and d is your 5. 4 plus 45, this is your 5, into 49. So sum of the 10 terms is 245. Okay. So, beta, time is over. You will do second part of this question as homework. Question number 1, second part is your homework.